Hello there, wrestling fans, and welcome to OFW. I am Daniel, your commentator, and tonight we've got an exciting match for you. Starting off with an OFW Tag Team Championship match between the Punks and USA Today. The Punks, in episode 1 of OFW, won against the Outlaws, and in episode 2, USA Today beat the Godfathers. And tonight, though, folks, we have got lots of important matches for many titles, for the tag team titles, for the cruiserweight title, and for the lightweight title. Plus, we have the do or die match for Stan tonight. He will be going against Haraguchi, where the winner will advance into the OFW tournament. But not only that, if Stan loses, he'll be gone from the OFW for good. That means there'll be no more Stan coming around, doing his thing, annoying Mr. Jenkins, our commissioner. But anyway, this match is going to be a very important for these teams, because these will be the very first tag team champions on our very first live air show on YouTube. Before, these two teams were former tag team champions on when before we could afford to come on the YouTube air. And now they will be, these either one of these two teams will be the very first YouTube tag team champions, if you will, because I was saying, this is the first time we actually got enough money, we saved up, and we finally got on air. And here comes USA Today. Now, this was a dominant team last week. They completely took the Godfathers, but the Godfathers did take them to the limit, but today the Punks are going to push them a bit further. And not only that, they've got the coolest intro theme ever. Hold on. The ghetto, fuck yeah, come on, fuck yeah, the gap, fuck yeah, face bam. So I am so sorry, folks, that is just a catchy tune. Slavery, not saying anything. But anyway, there we are, folks, the OFW Tag Team Championships. That's what they're going for tonight, and it's all on them. These teams look focused. And starting off, it looks like we have got Johnny in the ring, I think. Yes, that's Johnny. And then there's Tony Davis. And there was the bell. Now Johnny's punching Tony Davis. And there's a little punch off going off there. And now Tony Davis is just getting the assault. And now Tony Davis is picking up Johnny like a piece of meat. And oh, just throws him across the ring. That was pure. What? Low blow. Low blow straight off. It's been like, oh, and a boot, a right to the eyes. But ladies and gentlemen, this match is got to be an important match for these two teams, because this is just bragging rights. Apart from winning gold, it's bragging rights. And there's Johnny just cheating again. What the hell? And wait, backbreaker by Tony Davis. That could have. Oh, but another. What's the ref doing? The ref's just completely ballsing up this match when there's a tag. Wait, folks, we've got to be right back. We're going to another break. And we are back, folks, and we just saw a double team move by the Punks. And wait, there's this pin. This match is for the OFW Tag Team Championships, and it's the Punks versus USA Today. We just saw the Punks do a double team move against Tony Davis, and now Danny's in the ring, and I think Tony Davis just tagged into Bobby Harrison. And there's a spinning elbow to the face of Danny. And Bobby Harrison's going for the pin. One, two, no. It's only a two count, folks. But tonight we've got an exciting night for you, as we will decide three champions tonight. The tag team, the lightweight, and the cruiserweight title. Plus we'll have the do or die match for Stan tonight. He needs to win. Stay in OFW. Danny's got Bobby on his shoulders. Bobby Harrison fights and reverses into a DDT. What the hell? The ref just saw him boom in the balls. In fact, no, the ref stop. What the hell? If I wasn't so fat, I would go in there and beat the ref senseless. But I'm too fat and I'm stuck behind this commentator's desk. I'm sorry, folks, but the ref's still in there. We can't take him out. Sorry, folks. If I lost a bit of weight, you know, did a bit of slim fast and did a bit more masturbation, it might have made my weight go down a bit. But I'm sorry, folks. I'm rambling on. I need to come back to this match. And a boat in the eyes. A boat in the eyes. Like, the eyes are very important to wrestling. There's a scoop slam if you think about it, because if they don't have their eyes, they can't really see. And what the hell is Danny doing? He just hit the ref. He just hit the ref. What the hell? Well, now the ref's getting pushed. Yeah, I would be pissed too if some wrestler hit me. Yeah, but you still watch balls getting kicked. What the hell, ref? Honestly. What the hell is Bob? No! What the hell? Bobby Harris. Oh, and there's a clothesline down, and Danny's leaving the ring. What's he doing? The ref's still down. What's he getting? Is he got? He's got the title belts. No! He just hit him with a title belt. And he can't win like that. Wait, Bobby Harrison just got up. There's reverse DDT. That was just plain not right. I would go in there and knock Danny out. Bobby Harrison looks pissed. He just got a big flash of gold around the cheek. I mean, I'll be pissed too. I mean, there's another boot to the ball. Why are the refs stopping this? There's like seven boots to the balls now. And there's a double team. And Johnny just... yeah. Oh, right behind the ref's back. Boot to the face. And now Johnny's just choking Bobby Harrison. Why don't the ref get involved and stop this? I mean, seriously. Oh, there's another boot. Why don't the ref just disqualify the punks? Why? I don't get this. It's confusing, mate. And that is a double team. There's a double spine buster. And that two brothers going for the pin. This could be it. One, two. No. Only two count. What? Tony Davis just took the ref down and there's an arm drag. Now what the hell is Johnny doing? No. One. No. 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 Oh, what? Count out. Ref, forget about count out. You crazy fool. No, not this way. No. What's he doing? He's picked up Tony Davis. Tony Davis looks clueless. There's a punch and... I'll get to the... No! Punk face buster. A punk face buster. This is just a robbery. This is a pure... One! Two! No! That was a pure robbery. USA Today just got robbed out of the FW tag team titles. But he's down in the record books first. No! Not cool. Tony Davis looks clueless. What the hell? Well, anyway, folks, it looks like the punks have got the titles by cheating. If I wasn't so... I'll go and kick their ass. No, ref, you don't put their hand up in pride. You watch them boot in the balls. Come on. The ref was in here, I bet. I bet the ref was involved. But anyway, folks, on to our next match, which is the OFW Cruiserweight Championship match between Kobe Johnson with his girlfriend, the Ho, and John Jones. And here comes the wigger, Kobe Johnson, and... last week he was pretty impressive against El Majito, I've got to say. But now tonight he's bringing out the hoe, and they're called the Gangstas. Gangstas? Is that how you say it? Gangstas? I don't know, folks. I'm not cool. I'm still upset about that match. I mean, why? Tony Davis. I mean, why did he get it over the head? Shocking. That's just not right. That's not as cool. But anyway, folks, this is an important match. It's John Kid Jones. He beat Haku Genstar in the first episode to the JKM, the Jones Knockout. And last week, Kobe Johnson hit the wigger kick on El Majito, which basically that size 12 boot knocked out El Majito. I mean, El Majito was heavy as like a Mexican melon compared to that. And he's with his girlfriend, a Ho. Maybe a Ho, but she's got the biggest rack I have ever seen. And I'm like, wow. Match rack. But anyway, apart from that, that's most probably the wigger's babysitter for I know. And he's a wigger, go figure. Yeah, well, that rap says word. But anyway, here comes John the Kid Jones, and these were actually former cruiserweight champions, so they've had past gold, but of course we do not have the money to afford YouTube air. So now it's a clean slate, but the records books are now. Also, folks, just to let you know, the website is up, so you can go on it, you can check out the news, there's a forum, there's a chat room, you can go on there, you can check a roster, there might be some funny pictures of me in the bathroom. No, I'm only joking, folks, no. You've got to be 18 to see that. No, I'm only joking, folks, you won't see me in the bath, that's not right. But anyway, this match is going to get on the way in a minute, But this is an important match for these two, because John the Kid Jones, I think, did not qualify through against the qualifier in the tournament. Yeah, I think I'm right. He lost to... I'm not too sure who he lost to, but anyway, this match is for the OFW Cruiserweight Championship. And there's the belt, and we've got the same ref. You best not start conning, and this match is going to get underway in a minute. And there's the bell, and Jones is taunting. Woo! Yeah! So he just woo. And now, oh, well. And now, yeah. And with his headlock takedown. And John the Kid Jones, there's a cartwheel into an elbow drop. And that's a pretty impressive move. There's a pin. This could be it. One, two. Only a one count there. And now, John the Kid Jones. Oh! Backbreaker. There's a pin. One, two. It's all, I think this is it. No. Only two. This is an important match. I mean, but I think the main important match tonight is going to be the stand match. Wait a minute. There's a moonsault. A standing moonsault. And we're going to be right back, folks. And folks, we are back, and we just saw the Wigger do a moonsault, and he just done a springboard leg drop straight off the ropes. And John the Kid Jones reverses, and wait a minute. Rolling Thunder! A Rolling Thunder. But anyway, William, there's a pin. One, two, three. No, only a two count, folks, right there. But anyway, folks, yes, this is for the OFW Cruiserweight Championship. And if you tuned into this part, I suggest that you watched a bit before, unless you already watched it, so you actually know what's going on in OFW. And please make sure you do check out the website, because it's on the main page of OFW, so please check it out. It's a really good website. You can see pictures of naked chicks. We've got competitions. And soon, folks, we'll be hosting the very first OFW call search. So soon, just get your calls ready, and we'll give you a release date as soon as we'll find out the release date of the call search. But anyway, back to this match, and there's that Wigger breakdance move we saw last week. And that's a pretty nifty move. That could have break the legs. Break the necks. Break the necks. You ain't got one now. What the fuck am I saying? Wait a minute. There's a springboard reverse DDT. A springboard reverse DDT. And wait. Oh. That's a fuck. Oh. Yeah. Wait. What's this? He's picking up. He's got him. He's got him on his shoulders. Jones KO. The JKO. It's all over. One. Two. What? What? He kicked out of the JKO. And what the hell is the hoe doing? He's distracting the referee. And what the hell is John the Kid Jones doing? Reverse DDT. What the hell? What the hell was the hoe doing? Was she just flashing a rack off to the ref? I mean, come on. If you want to flash your rack, flash it over here. I mean, come on. And there's another headlock takedown thing with his legs. And what the hell is he doing? Well, there's a reversal. But if she wants to flash a rack, she can flash him over here. Shooting star press, and there's the pin. What? Not even roll one? I am surprised. Wait. Oh! Double takedown with the hand. Again, not even a one. What the hell? And there's an arm drag. A beautiful arm drag. Takedown by John Kid Jones there. Misses. Oh, and it kicks him around the side of the head. Oh, he's picking him up again. And another JKO. This is it now. The hoe looks disappointed. Her man has not got the title. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7. The hoe distracted the ref again. Flashing the rack. And now John the Kid Jones is getting an advantage. Oh, and there's a leg drag takedown by John the Kid Jones. What? I'm John the Kid Jones. What am I? I wonder, what's Kobe Johnson doing? Oh, shoulder first straight into the turnbuckle. Wow. What, your small package does roll up. One, two. That ref is counting really neat. I think the ref is a bit slow. I think he's a bit mentally retarded here in the FW arena tonight. What's that ref called? Referee Colonel Clustered. Yeah. Screw you, Referee Colonel Clustered. Yeah, you're gay. Yeah, you better be hollow.
There's a punch and... Oh, and there's a kick up on John the Kid Jones by Kobe Johnson. He's throwing him into the corner here. And there's a boot to the back of John the Kid Jones with a size 12 gangster wigger boot. What the hell? He's taunting. Is that balling? Or is that how big his penis is? What the hell does that mean? I don't know. I'm sorry, folks. I'm just an average white guy. I don't understand this code. I mean, what does that mean? Does that mean there's a basketball or something? Or does that mean that's how big he is? Or does that mean he's not erect? I don't know. But anyway, there's a springboard elbow off the ropes. That was pretty impressive. Not much John the Kid Jones doing. He just did the referee, Dan. What? Yeah. But yeah, the ref deserves a beating tonight. Wait, where's the hoe doing? What's the hoe? The hoe's bringing in them lovely bubbly boobs, but what the hell? And this head on the table, but no! What the? Cheer shot! What? Why? And another cheer shot, and John the Kid Jones is busted open, and now the wig is just taking cheer outside the ring. What? No! And there's a clothesline, I'm assuming. There's a backdrop. The ref was clueless just about that attack, and there's a spinning leg drop. There's a roll up. This could be it. One, two, three. No, only two. But the ref's just completely clueless about that chair shot a minute ago by Kobe Johnson. The host getting involved. And there's that. Is he on erect? I don't know. But wait a minute. He's going back. He's going back. Oh, wigger kick. The wigger kick. He hits the wigger kick. One, two, no. Why? That's not... two titles now have been cheated out. What the hell's going on? Well, now we know, folks, who our Cruiserweight champion is. It's Kobe Johnson. Folks, we will be right back. Why? Why use that weapon? Folks, we'll be right back. I'm sorry, folks. Hello there, wrestling fans, and we are back. And right now, we've got the OFW Lightweight Championship match between Billy Ray Cyrus and the Lizard. Billy Ray Cyrus, he actually beat none other than Fabio to actually get this title opportunity. And the Lizard beat Haraguchi. They are two high names in the lightweight division, folks. I mean, Fabio's a former lightweight champion. He's a former six-time OFW champion. And Billy Ray Cyrus hit that achy breaky hard, and he put him down. And I was all like, yes! But anyway, folks, you know that I like Billy Ray Cyrus, but forget it. Not in a game thing. But he's got everything going recently. He's got a victory over against Fabio. That's going on. His record good. He's got everything going right for him. He's still got a slutty daughter though, and she's all about YouTube and doing dance-offs and with like, and then what the book comes along, and he does all this stuff. But anyway, folks, let's forget about that. But coming in the ring in a minute will be his opponent, the Lizard. This is going to be a pretty exciting match, as these two have never ever met before. But I'm assuming that the Lizard has checked the tapes of Billy Ray Cyrus, not when he's singing the Achy Breaky Heart song or anything like that. And the most probably Billy Ray Cyrus has watched videos of the Lizard, and they have scouted for all the different moves that they can do. But all Lizard has to do is hit the Lizard Bite, which is that face buster, and that's it. It's lights out for Billy Ray Cyrus. And all Billy Ray Cyrus has to do is hit the Achy Breaky Heart, and once again, lights out for the Lizard. But the winner of this match will become the OFW Lightweight Champion, and will be the first OFW Lightweight Champion to be on YouTube Air. So it's a very big pride and honorable thing, as you can also boast. But there we go, folks. That's the championship they're going for, the OFW Lightweight Championship. And here we go, folks. This match will get underway in a minute. And here we are, and this is going to be an exciting match for these two. And there's a lockup straight off the, and there's a small package. This could be it. One, two, no, only two count. But anyway, yes, folks, we've also still got that do or die match tonight with Stan. and he'll be taking on Haraguchi. But not only that, the winner will qualify for the OFW tournament. So that, if Stan wins, not only will he get a contract, it's double win for him, as he will also get a chance to actually win the OFW championship if he can win this match and then carry on winning through the tournament. But anyway, Lizard's going up on top rope and he stamps on the leg of Billy Ray Cyrus. If Billy Ray Cyrus loses his legs, that will stop him doing the achy breaky heart, as he needs to get on top rope. And there's a throw to the corner. Billy Ray Cyrus, he's got the Lizard up. And there's a Lucha DDT out the turnbuckle. And there's the pin. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now only a 2 count. Ref can't count to 4 because they only know 3. For some reason, I think that's only the refs get paid just to know how to count to 3. And that's it. But there's a Boston Crab. And he's wrenching the back of Billy Ray Cyrus.
Road break.
And Billy Ray Cyrus must have got to the ropes then, I'm assuming. Oh, and there's a reversal. Oh, DDT. That just spiked him on the Lizards. And the Billy Ray Cyrus is going up the top rope. Wait a minute. Oh, and there's an elbow to the face. I thought he was going for the bit of make break your heart then. And he's going up again. He could be going for it. No. Only another. Just an elbow to the face. That's happened last week. And then it was shared to last week. What happened to Fabio? Well, the first week. Oh, wait. Throwing him out of the ring. Triangle drop kick. A drop kick and he sent the Lizard flying out. And Billy Ray Cyrus should keep on the offense. What the hell? Why is he keeping offense? Rest out on a free, can't we? Wait a minute. Flip center. Yes. A flip corkscrew over the ropes. Oh, yeah. That was awesome. And now the Lizard's got the advantage, even though he just received that flip corkscrew over the ropes, and the rest out to 4. And he's right next to our announce table. Wait, could you please get away, guys? Please. I don't want you near my announce table. I mean, it costs quite. No, leave my announce. No! Not my monitors. What the hell? You just don't go breaking my monitors and making them fall through the floor, make them vanish. What's this? Oh, he kind of hits him there with a crossbody, I'm assuming. I think he hit the top of Billy Ray Cyrus's mullet, and that mullet shot made it go through his body. I think that's what happened. Now Lizard just kicks Billy Ray Cyrus, and they're coming back over here. Go away, guys. I don't want no more trouble. Go away. Wait a minute. Where they going? Where the hell are they going? They're going over the barricade. Taking this fight into the crowd, folks. The fans are putting more to what they paid for. They thought they'd just be sitting behind a barricade watching the wrestlers, but the wrestlers are bringing it to them. And wait a minute. And now he's running back, and there's another clothesline straight back over the barricade. That was quick. And now the fans are getting back, but the refs on the count of 5. They've got to get back in the ring. Wait a minute. No, get him away. He's on my announce table. Go away. Go away. Oh, I've got to get out of here. I'm getting out of here. I'm back. Wait a minute! A crossbody! All the way from the turnbuckle! All the way to the announce table! Oh my god! Yes! Oh, Billy Ray Cyrus could be broken! And I've got back to my announce table, folks! Luckily it didn't break, but that was one hell of a move! Oh! Billy Ray Cyrus is waiting up on top rope. What's he doing? He's talking to the fans, but that was a brilliant move by the Lizard. Wait, oh, the Lizard falls! And, oh! Billy Ray Cyrus just got his Billy Balls busted! 2! No! Only a 2 card. And there's a headlock takedown. But by the Lizard, and there's a leg wrench with the legs on the head. Like a mini grand head scissors. And now, Billy Ray Cyrus. Wait a minute. He calls this a Miley Cyrus move when she's been a naughty girl. This is what he does to Miley Cyrus when she's been bad. He spanks her like that. Apparently, that's what I read on Wikipedia. Check it out. It don't lie. But anyway, folks. We just saw a brilliant cross body. Oh, and there's a drop kick in the corner. Oh, Bronco Buster. Putting his Billy Ray balls in Lizard's face, and there's a light on, there's a pin. One, two, no, only two. What the hell? Wait, backdrop. And there's a leg drop takedown. But anyway, Cyrus is pulling the lizard. I want to say thank you, folks, for watching this. Wait a minute. He's jumping. He's jumping. Oh, yes, he's jumped. Oh, he stepped in motion. Oh, the achy breaky. Oh, the achy breaky. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. But he's taunting. He should get the pin. Why don't he get the pin? Wait a minute. Lizard just reversed. Oh, moonsault! The moonsault! We just saw the achy breaky heart by Billy Ray Cyrus, and that jumping leg drop! That was a pretty nifty move, that was pretty cool. And that Billy Ray Cyrus, he should have stayed on the offense, and now the lizard's just fighting back! And there's a Boston Crab in the middle of the ring! Nowhere to go! And he's wrenching the back of Billy Ray Cyrus! But anyway, Cyrus fought out of it. Now, what's this? Chop! A chop by Billy Ray Cyrus, but once again the lizard reverses. Now, the lizard is springing off the ropes. A springboard drop kick, and Billy Ray Cyrus is out. And he's going for the lizard behind. I think, no, he got reversed by Billy Ray Cyrus. And there's a heel kick. What's this? Wait a minute, what's he going for? He's waiting for Lizard to get up. The Lizard got up and there's a Hurricane Rana! A Hurricane Rana by Billy Ray Cyrus. Now the Lizard reverses once again. Oh, and there's another moonsault, another standing moonsault. Wait. Throws him into the turnbuckle and monkey flip. This match has been an all-out extreme high-flying brawl. There's a springboard leg drop by the lizard. This has been an exciting match. Wait a minute! Oh, lizard bite! The lizard bite! He hit the lizard right! That could have knocked out Billy Ray Cyrus! He hit the lizard bite! One, two, three! Ladies and gentlemen, we have got your very first OFW Flyweight Champion, the Lizard. He beat Billy Ray Cyrus. This match was pure excitement. The crossbody off the announcer's table. Oh, and then thrown into the crowd. This was, and then the achy break off. But it finished it all with a lizard bite. Please, fans, please tune in. We will be right back. Yay! Hello wrestling fans and welcome back, and yes, here it is, OFW Crashdown, our very first CPV that will be coming out soon, and Nirvana in Bloom is our theme tune for that. But coming up now, here we go, it's a film match actually, really, between the Godfathers and the Outlaws. Recently though, these two teams have both suffered defeats from USA Today and the Punks. The Outlaws lost to the Punks and the Godfathers lost to USA Today. So this match is pretty much, this match will just make, it's like a rubber match between these two. They lost them two matches, so now they go against each other. But the problem is the Outlaws have actually been having miscommunication problems in the team. So they've just been arguing a lot. I mean, early on today, they was trying to sort out they had to put on the chaps, then the underpants, then the jeans, and the redneck was having none of it. He says you put your underpants on last, and Gunslinger said don't be stupid. They just argue over anything recently. They even argue how to masturbate. That's how bad this team is having miscommunication problems. But anyway, here comes their opponents now, the Godfathers, the father-son team of Aldo and Franco. These two did put up a fight against USA Today last week, but sadly they came up short against them. But tonight they are hoping that they will actually win a match. None of these teams have won yet this season in the OFW, so this is a really, really important chance for these two teams to win, because if they don't win, then they're screwed, basically, because they will never become into the tag team title run if they do not win matches. Anyway, folks, I'd like to say thank you for watching OFW, and I hope you do enjoy the show. But anyway, this match is getting, looks like it's going to be on the way in a minute. It's a singles match. It was just Gunslinger versus Aldo. I thought it was a tag team match, but there's a lockup, and that and it's beating each other down. But this is an important match, as these two teams could decide who the tag team champions, number one contenders are. And it's a reversal by Aldo on Gunslinger. Oh, there's the clothesline, and here we go. Oh, there's a reversal by Gunslinger. Aldo was just gonna punch him to. Oh, and there's a choke by Gunslinger. What the hell is he thinking? And Redneck's enjoying seeing it, but Aldo reverses the a punch and headbutts back Gunslinger, and there's a drop kick, and Gunslinger just falls like a sack of spuds, like a sack of potatoes. And DDT! There's a DDT! And here's the pin. One! What? He just overpowered the Aldo from the Godfathers. Gunslinger just overpowered him. And now he's going up on top rope. Elbow drop! There's an elbow drop! This could be it! One, two, no, only two can't. But yes, folks, this is an exciting, this is an important match. But also, what's really important is the main event tonight, the Do or Die match between Stan and Haraguchi. The winner will go through the OFW tournament, but the loser will, but if Stan loses, sorry, he will leave the OFW for good. That's going to be an important match for Stan, as his whole career, which hasn't even got started yet in the OFW, could end tonight. And also, you saw an advertisement for OFW Crashdown, the very first CPU. They are still deciding when to have it, but there is going to be all the titles, plus there will be the final of the OFW tournament for the OFW Championship, plus the two semi-final matches. So it's going to be an exciting night, and we hope you do tune into that, our very first CP view, and I hope you do enjoy watching our show. Anyway, back to it. Looks like Aldo's torn. He should stay in the offense against Gunslinger. Oh, he just clotheslines him down and laying him punches into Gunslinger's head. Oh, an elbow drop. Back chop, not a back drop. I'm sorry, folks, I completely tittered that up. Oh, drop kick straight to the face. That could have not broke the Gunslinger's nose. Oh, it'll kick to the stomach. And oh, Sicilian boot! The Sicilian boot! Straight from Italia! This Italian Sicilian boot! Flea! Mamma mia! Aldo won! And that means that once again, the Redneck does not look happy that Gunslinger just got a Sicilian boot to the face! This is going to be tough on the Outlaws now. They have not won a match here in OFW, but the Godfathers have won this round. But the thing is, though, will the Outlaws actually get a win and actually start communicating? But folks, we will be right back. Welcome back, fans, and we've had an exciting night. We have just made three champions. We saw the tag team championship, the lightweight championship, and the cruiserweight championship to be decided. We also saw an exciting tag match between the Outlaws and the Godfathers. But now, ladies and gentlemen, for this week's episode of OFW Extreme, here is the main event. It is the do or die match between Stan and Haraguchi, where the winner will actually go through and advance and go through the FW tournament, sorry. But right now, Mr. Jenkins is coming into the ring to give some word of advice or encouragement for his nephew, Stan, I don't know. Well, we know that Rene Sambo's just been giving Mr. Jenkins a hands-on approach. Oh, that's a bit freaky. I mean, he's a ginger. But anyway, this is an important time for Stan. He needs to be 100% focused and determined to win. And this could be the last match time we see him. What the hell does he trip over? Every time! I mean, he trips over the exact same bit. mean, you can't just trip over the same part every time. I mean, you trip over it once, yeah, you trip over it again, okay, that's fine, but not about seven times now. I mean, come on, Stan. You've got to win this to stay in OFW. You know, just fall about on the floor. Aww. Oh, there it comes. Oh, he trips up. What the hell? Why does he keep doing that? But anyway, Spanny's in the ring. And wow. Oh. Well, that was some really harsh words there. I mean, I think Mr. Jenkins should not have said that. That was a bit too harsh against Stan's mother. Oh. I apologize, Mrs. Jenkins, that, Mrs. Jenkins' sister. But anyway, here it comes. Here's the match, and here comes Araguchi. The winner of this will be caught, will advance through the OFW tournament. But it is another stake on the line. If Stan wins this, not only will he advance through, he will finally get OFW contract. But he is not against an easy opponent. But sadly, Haraguchi did not win against the Lizard to go for the lightweight title, but he's got a better opportunity here. But anyway, folks, this match will get on the way now, and the rest in the ring, and it looks like we're going to start. This is an important match for Stan. He needs to win this, and there's the bell, and off we go, and there's a crossbody straight off. This could be a nice pin. One, two, no, only two count. This is an important match for Stan. He needs to win this. But Stan's been training a lot. I've seen him actually at the training camp. He actually can do some cool moves. But he's against a professional here. And wait a minute. There's a Lucha DDT. Straight out the turnbuckle. And there's another pin. One, two, three, two. And only a two count. I'm pretty surprised that Stan can actually kick out. And now, leg drop. Another leg drop. And what the hell was this? And there's a moonsault! Wow! And Haraguchi's taunting, I think he knows that he's going to win this match. I mean, he's like, not let's seem worried. There's a springboard leg drop on Stan. Stan's got no offense in this match yet. He has not got nothing yet. There's a splitting leg moonsault! He has had no offense in this match yet. One, two! Only two count right here. Stan has had no offense. He needs to get some offense going or something. Oh, there's some punch by Araguchi. Wait, Araguchi. There's a knee by Stan. And just taking blows back and forwards. And what's... Stan... got him on the way back. Stan jumped over the first of him in Segura. But did not get over the second one. But Stan has got no offense in this match yet. Stan looks hurt already. Stan needs to get something done. Wait, leg drop. And... another leg drop. Stan needs to get this offense going. Wait, Stan. Stan tripped up Araguchi. And he could have put a pin. This could be it. He could have a contract. One. Two. No. Sorry, folks. Got to be excited there. Knock my mic. Oh, and Stan's. Enziguri. Stan just did an Enziguri on Araguchi. Why? Here's another pin. What? No. Not even a one count. What the hell? Oh, and a knee to the gut. By Stan. And there's another pin. One. Two! He could have it! No! Only a two count. Stan's actually getting some offense now. There's an Irish whip into the corner. Stan's laying forms into Haraguchi's back. Stan looks like he's been training very well. He's actually pulling off some moves. Oh! Wait, Stan, what's he doing? Elbow drop! He learned that from Billy Ray Cyrus. Wait a minute. One, two, he's got a contract. Three, no! Only a two count. Stan. Hello, Tatan. He has advanced in his training. But Araguchi reverses. He says, oh, and there's a sweep of the legs. Now Araguchi's up on top rope. Oh, another split leg moonsault on Stan. This could be it. One, two, no. Only two count. This is an important match. And if Stan wins this, it will be unbelievable. Headlock takedown by Araguchi, sorry. But Stan's got a lot to get going. He's got to start moving. Wait a minute, what's he doing? Hoguchi is getting closer. What's a springboard clothesline? A springboard clothesline by Stan. A springboard. Oh my god. One. Two. No. No. Stan could have had this match won. What's this? Oh, what the hell was that? Stan's begging. What's he begging for? And he's dancing. He looks on fire. Stan is on fire with that white man's dance. And he's back up on top rope. He's waiting for Haraguchi to get up. Wait, Haraguchi's got up. What's this? Cross-border. He just rolling cross-body across the ring. What's he doing? Up. Oh, jumping knee. A jumping knee to the face. What's Stan's doing? Wait a minute. Stan's picking him up. Wait a minute. He's got him up. Stamplex! The Stamplex! He just hit the Stamplex on Haraguchi! Oh my god! Two! Three! Stan's done it! Stan has got the OFW contract and it is advanced in the OFW tournament! Stan has won! This is then a good story night for Stan as he has won his first match against Haraguchi and has just got his contract! Folks, this has been an exciting night of OFW. We've seen three champions. We've seen a contract being won by Stan. And folks, we thank you for watching OFW. But wait a minute. Something's going on in the back. I've just got word for something's going on in the back. What's going on in the back? Wait, that's Fabio and the Lizard. We saw Lizard earlier on tonight. What the hell? What proposition? What? What's Fabio whispering? What's he saying? Wait. What's he on about? He's in. What's going on? Well, folks, we'll be back next week. Tune in next week.